Hi, it's Kim, and today I'm going to be talking about featherweights. No, not the boxers. I'm talking about the Singer featherweight sewing machines. Do you know about these? Well, I didn't know anything about them either till about a year ago, and I'm blaming this on Facebook because one of my quilting acquaintances was talking about a featherweight machine she saw advertised for sale at the local Goodwill shop. Well, sale and sewing machine is, you know, kind of the favorite things I like to hear, so off I went to check it out, and I really didn't know much about them before I got there, but there it was, and it was really cute, and it looked great, but, you know, I'm not going to buy it without seeing if it's going to work or not, so I thought I'd check it out, but again, I hadn't really done my research, so I didn't have much with me as far as, you know, a needle to put in the thing, and it had no manual, so I didn't know how to even change a needle or put in the bobbin, and by the way, the bobbins go in pretty much the opposite to how you'd usually do it on your modern sewing machine, so I couldn't get it to work. So I thought, I better think about this for a little bit. Again, not knowing anything about them. So I went home, thought about it, and of course, you know, it was sold out from underneath me. But that's okay because I checked on Kijiji, still looking for a featherweight 221. And there was a lady really close to me who had one for sale. So great, I go over there. And, you know, I had a wedding later that day, you know, an hour or two later. But hey, that's not a problem. So over I went. Checked it out. This time I had done a bit of research, so I did know how things worked on it, and I guess I didn't have fabric, but she had some fabric we tried, and I could kind of get it to go, and, you know, I could see it looked like it was going to be okay, and it was in great shape. Came in a box and everything, so I was very excited about it, but even more exciting when I was there is I noticed, because the models are on the front of these machines, that it didn't say 221, it said 222K. So I knew a little bit about what that was. And when I got it home, I explored a little further and I found out that the 222K is a limited production featherweight that they had. They were produced from about 1953 to 1961, so a short production run. Portable, like the original 221 featherweights, but it had some extra advantages. And I'll show you about those in a few minutes. So remember I told you there were some special features on the 222K, a little different than the 221. So it's their free arm machine. So you can see the bed goes up and down just like the 221. But what this little guy does, which is really interesting, is it's a free arm. So it comes right off and then you're left with a small arm here. And you can see it's a, they call it a tubular bed because it's kind of, you can see it's rounded here. And so this is great for hemming or doing cuffs, that type of thing, of course, it's great. Because the other one doesn't have that. So that's kind of exciting. It took me a little while to figure out how to take it off, but, you know, it screws on, screws off. Very easy. The other thing it does is it also has a lever on the front which says sew or down darn on it. And so when you're regularly sewing, it's going to be up in the sewing position, but when you put it down to darn, guess what it does? It drops those feed dogs down. So it's great for free motion quilting, although I think it might be a little narrow of a bed to do some free motion quilting on, but still, if you're darning, that was what it was made for. In addition, it's got a bobbin winder, as do all the machines, and a nice little light on the front that works really well. And so that's my 222K.